In this video, you will learn how to create and use assignment records to manage your organization's training requirements. Assignment records are used to set up templates for required training and retraining. Some organizations use the term training matrix to describe this functionality. You can configure the training requirements for an entire personnel group or job role or for a specific individual. As new personnel are added to personnel groups or job roles, they will automatically inherit the required training assignments for their group and job roles. By assigning courses to a group or job role, you can avoid the tedious management of individual courses to personnel and focus on the overall training needs for the organization. For special cases, however, you may still assign a course to a specific individual if needed. Before creating an assignment for an individual, consider whether your organization has hired or may hire another person with this requirement. If so, you may wish to add a job role and then create a job role assignment instead so that you can add or remove the job role from personnel as needed to automatically update their required training. Note that job roles and training manager are different than an organizational job title. You can create an unlimited number of job roles and training manager, and each person can have many job roles to reflect the various types of work they do. This is a flexible and efficient way of standardizing and grouping related training requirements and then adding or removing those requirements for individuals by checking or unchecking the job role on their personnel form. Okay, let's take a look at an example. We will begin by creating a new assignment record. You can set the scope of the assignment to a group, job role, or individual, as you see here. The assignment will then apply to anyone within the scope you have selected. We will begin with a group assignment. You can choose whether to include subgroups or not by checking or unchecking the Include Subgroups checkbox. You can select the group from the selection field, or if you have a hierarchy of groups and need help identifying the right one, you can use the search button which shows the groups with the full hierarchy displayed. Next, you can select the required training course and then begin setting the options. The first option to set is the initial training. You can set the initial training to be due by hire date, with or without a grace period, or immediately, or by a specific date. The option for hire date plus 30 days is commonly used for new hire training. This gives the new employee a grace period of 30 days before the training will be overdue on the status reports. If the training has not been completed, but is still within the grace period, it will appear with the status untrained. After the grace period is over, it will appear as overdue, if it has not yet been completed. Otherwise, the training will appear as up to date. If you want the training to be overdue immediately, you can set the initial training to be due immediately. In this case, there is no grace period, and the training status will be displayed as overdue for anyone within the scope of this assignment. You can also set a specific date for the initial training. This can be used for a new training course which has been added to the requirements and must be completed within a period of time, for example, by the end of the year. Next, you can set the retraining frequency. This setting is used to configure how often the training must be taken in order to be considered up to date. The training has expired when it is no longer up to date. If the frequency is set to one time only, then no retraining is required. If the frequency is set to repeat every 3 years, then the expiration date will be set to 3 years after the last completion date. You can also set the frequency to repeat when the course version changes. This can be used to require retraining when a related document has been updated. For example, some organizations create a training course for each of their standardized procedures and then require retraining when the procedure has been updated. This course version information is managed on the course form. The retraining will be required on the effective date of the course version. If you have a minor version update which you do not want to trigger retraining for, such as an update for a typo in the course materials, you can uncheck the required checkbox. If you have an SOP, a procedure, or some other related training document, you can enter the information here, including an optional document version which allows you to use an alphanumeric identifier. In addition to updating the version when there has been a change to the training, you can also set retraining to be required on a set schedule such as the same time each year by creating a new course version for each year. You will notice that this option is slightly different than the option to require retraining every 12 months. For the requirement of training due every 12 months, the expiration date will be 12 months after the last date when the training was completed, which may be any time during the year depending on when the training was last completed for a particular individual. On the other hand, a version-based assignment can be used to require the retraining by January 1st of each year, or any other set schedule, as needed. After all of the assignments have been set up for your organization, you can easily identify upcoming training requirements by running the overdue and upcoming status report. This will list all overdue training, as well as training which will be due within the time frame you have set for the report. There are several grouping options which can be used to organize the report for individual personnel, a group, a supervisor, or a trainer, etc. You can see the line item details on the report, or select the summary report for a roll-up summary. The required training report is a similar report which shows all required training including up-to-date training. This report can be used to identify the training compliance rates based on the group setting. Many organizations email out a copy of this report once per month so that the training can be scheduled with the various trainers, supervisors, and personnel, as needed. After you have identified training to be scheduled, you can schedule class sessions to perform the training. When scheduling the sessions, you can use the shortcut to select all assigned personnel, or selected personnel based on their current training status.